Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a professional copy editor who shares writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. Today's tutorial shows how to create, change, and delete tabs in Microsoft Word. At the end, we'll also look at how to change your default tab. When you press the tab key while working in Word, your cursor moves to a specific location called a tab stop. Tabs can be used to indent paragraphs, but they can also be used for other purposes, including creating single and multi-column lists. Please note that although tabs can be used to indent paragraphs, Word's built-in indent options are more efficient and reliable for longer documents. Please see my other video titled Three Ways to Indent Paragraphs in Microsoft Word for more information. Today, I'll be using Word for Office 365, which is currently the same as Word 2019. The steps are the same in Word 2016, Word 2013, and Word 2010. Before starting the tutorial, let's quickly look at the different types of tab stops you can use in Word. Word includes five different tab stops. The left tab places left-aligned text to the right of the stop. This is the most common tab stop. The center tab centers text on the stop. The right tab places right-aligned text to the left of the stop. The decimal tab aligns text based on the first decimal placed on the stop. And the bar tab creates a vertical line at the stop. But technically, this isn't a tab. It's a formatting device primarily used for multi-column lists. Now we're going to create, change, and delete tabs by using the ruler. You can also perform these actions in the Tabs dialog box. However, that process is less user-friendly than the ruler method, so it will be presented in a separate tutorial. Most importantly, please note that these steps don't apply to your default tab, which we'll cover later in this video. If your ruler isn't visible, select the View tab in the ribbon, and then select Ruler in the Show group. If you want to add tabs to existing text, press Ctrl+A on your keyboard to select the entire document, or select the portion of your document to which you want to apply the tab. If you don't select all or part of your existing document before creating your new tab, it will only be accessible to the paragraph your cursor is currently in or to newly created text. Next, click the Tab Selector button until it changes to the symbol representing the tab you want. You can hover your pointer over each symbol in the Tab Selector for a tooltip explaining each symbol. I'm going to select the left tab. Once you've made your selection, click the location on the ruler where you would like to place the tab stop. The tab symbol will then appear on the ruler. Note that you can place multiple tab stops on the ruler. Each time you press the tab key, your cursor will move to the next stop. If you want to change the location of a tab stop and update all the text formatted with that tab, select only that text. Then, slide the tab symbol to a new location on the ruler. If you want to delete a tab from the ruler, first ensure that no text is selected, then pull the tab symbol downward and release it. It will be removed from the ruler. If you accidentally delete a tab, immediately press Ctrl+Z on your keyboard to undo the deletion. Now let's change your default tab. If you haven't manually created any tabs, Word moves your cursor half an inch to the right when you press the tab key on your keyboard. However, you can change the length of your default left tab stop without creating a new tab. The following steps only affect your current document. If you want to change the default tab for all future documents, you have to modify your normal template. We'll cover that advanced topic in a separate tutorial. Also note that the default tab doesn't appear on the ruler like the tabs we just created manually. To begin, select the Home tab in the ribbon. Then, select the Dialog Box Launcher in the Paragraph group. Now, select the Tabs button in the Paragraph dialog box. Use the increment arrows to adjust the default tab stop in the Tabs dialog box. Alternatively, you can type a new number directly into the text box. I'm going to change my default tab to 1 inch. When you're finished, select the OK button to close the Tabs dialog box. Now when I press the Tab key on my keyboard, my cursor moves 1 inch. The companion blog post for this video listing all the steps we just performed appears on erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Microsoft Word or Adobe Acrobat that you'd like me to address in the future. And please subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.